गुड इवनिंग फ्रेंड्स, यू आर मोस्ट वेलकम टू थिंकाइस चैनल। टुडे वी आर डिस्कसिंग द आरएसटीवी डिबेट, द बिग पिक्चर, नॉर्थ ईस्ट ग्रोथ पोटेंशियल। इंट्रोडक्शन। नॉर्थ ईस्ट हैज़ द पोटेंशियल टू बिकम इंडियाज ग्रोथ इंजन, सेड प्राइम मिनिस्टर मोदी ऑफ इंडिया। वाइल असर्टिंग द पीस हैज़ नाउ बीन एस्टैब्लिश्ड इन द रीजन, स्पीकिंग आफ्टर लेइंग the foundation stone for the Manipur water supply project through video conferencing, the Prime Minister Modi highlighted that modern infrastructure is being built to improve connectivity. India's Northeast, in a way, is the gateway to our ancient cultural relationships with East Asia and the future of trade, travel and tourism. Why RSTV? RSTV assumes significance for UPSC Civil Services Examination, as it touches the current happenings of all areas with relevant inputs. Here we are providing gist of Rajasabha TV discussion on Northeast growth potential. Topic relevance from RSTV debates on Northeast growth potential for UPSC. Direct question can be asked on potential of Northeast Indian region to be India's growth, natural resources of the region and potential for the growth, challenges in the region, recent project in the region, blah blah blah. Edited excerpts from the debate. Why India's Northeast region is so important? It is amongst the most recent geographical territories that has become part of our general Indian polity, so there are a lot of expectation from rest of India. This region is one of the mega biodiverse hotspots in the world and amongst the most heavily forested area in the country. The region represents 25% of the country's forest coverage. The social and educational attainments level of the people is very high in the region of the country. The region represents 8% of the territory of the country and is home to large number of ethnic communities, which represents a very diverse culture. Before the partition, Northeast was a vibrant region and it was connected through Kolkata, Chittagong and used to be transported or transportation hub. Kolkata, Chittagong. These are the ports. One is in West Bengal, second is in Bangladesh. Issues, challenges within the Northeast region. There has been a sense of isolation owing to loss of identity and loss of geographical connectivity with the rest of the country, especially post-partition. There have been a general neglect from political as well as social point of view. Loss of connectivity after the partition has led to a deepening of identity crisis, which the region suffers from. Despite having high levels of literacy, the region suffers from lack of employment opportunities. The private sector and the industrial investment was very low and the transaction cost in the region is very high, very much higher for the investors as compared to the other region, which is one of the major cause. What is being done to address the problems relating to Northeast? It was in 1996 when the first Northeast package was developed, and that was the stepping stone when attention was focused on Northeast. Way back in 2005, we have Northeast Vision 2020, which identified the potential rate of growth as well as the potential where we could focus upon to ensure that the region and its state reaches the national average. Many policies like Lucky's policy has expanded the perspective within the Northeast as well as adjoining areas. The region has been highly troubled for the last 4-5 decades, but the level of conflict is coming down, not only because of security actions but also because of younger generations is much more integrated and mainstreamed into the rest of the country, and they have different kinds of expectations from the society. The situation appears to be improving, particularly because from the policy perspective, the focus on the East Asian countries have increased and improved relations with Bangladesh. The government plan to connect all the capital cities on of the region is good move in this direction. What needs to be done? There is a need to overcome the issue of connectivity and take Northeast region into stride and develop this region as a tool of mainstreaming the entire Northeast society and also using this region as a launch pad for our connection with the Southeast Asia region. When we talk about Northeast region, we cannot ignore Bangladesh. The better the relation with Bangladesh in terms of foreign policy, cultural exchange, social linkages, etc., the better will be the economic impact on the region. We have observed in the last 10 years that Northeast region can reach its potential provided that the security aspect is taken care of, which indirectly is going to reduce the transaction cost. There is need to encourage younger generation, give them enough opportunities for growth and as much help as possible for bringing normalcy to the region. We have to look at the possible areas where we can invest in this region and let it grow. There may not be the need to follow the industrial model of development just like the rest of the country. We have to look at the kind of natural resources like bamboo, which can not only be used in making furniture but also for making biofuels, which is a sunrise industry. The rivers in this region are abundant with water and we need to have a proper flood and water management policy here, which can not only help in mitigating its water needs but also stabilize the ecosystem of the rest of the country. We have to take into account the development initiatives with the younger people's aspirations, taking care of the ecological aspect and economic imperatives. The political aspect have to be managed a little better to ensure that the outcomes of these efforts lead to a stable environment. Because of higher literacy and better English speaking skills of the younger generation, the service-based activity like BPO can be future prospect. But along with this, the ecological aspect must be taken care of, especially considering sharp decline in the forest cover in the states of Arunachal Pradesh, Nagaland, Mizoram, as per India State of Forest Report 2019. The area is agro-based and the forest cover is quite large, so there is need to be a focus on how to develop these elements, keeping in mind the development of the people and deriving the socio-economic benefit and opportunities. There is a rationale for implementing inner-line permit, but we have to look beyond without disturbing the ethnic and socio-economic fabric of the Northeast. While retaining the socio-economic framework of the Northeast, we need to do certain innovative activities which attract investment and people's opportunity without disturbing the biodiversity. Conclusion. The environment and investment opportunities in the region are improving, with the younger generation acquiring higher skills, getting better educational opportunities outside the region can help in bringing up the investment opportunities in the region. We need to emphasize the natural resources potential of the region and to be able to tap its full potential. There should be an integrated approach which encompasses the surrounding areas of the country and concentrate on the specialist of the region and specialties of the region. The growth should be people centric without disturbing the natural ecology of the region. The ethnic aspiration of the people should be safeguarded and carried forward as well as in a very positive manner, and that as a whole will ensure that the entire region is far more integrated with mainland India. This region has a lot of potential for growth in itself and to also take forward the look east policy, which is very important from a strategic as well as political point of view. While we are talking about the Northeast, we should see the bigger picture for not only the development of the Northeast region, but for the benefit of the country as a whole also. Thank you very much.